The thing about science is that once you understand a theory, a postulation, or a phenomena, or a law for that matter, well enough, you can apply that and make use of it in various different situations. In the previous video, we saw how by doubling the distance of the light source from the subject, we realized how we can control the light fall off. This video is about how the inverse square law applies to another situation, okay, and how light behaves in that situation with regard to the, or rather with relation to the background and the subject, and how the light fall off affects and makes the picture look, or the image look, appear differently each time you move the light away from the subject. I am Radhakrishnan. Welcome to another video from Pixel Village. So to demonstrate our point, as usual, we have an uncomplicated setup. We have the light and we have the background, and of course, we have our model too. Isha, please come over. Isha is going to be staying exactly in the same place she did in the previous video. The background is going to remain exactly where it is now. I am going to be staying stationary here with my camera and one lens. All is going to change is the position of the light. We're going to start from a very close distance, and we're going to keep moving backwards and keep taking shots every time. As per the law, when the light is close to the subject, the fall off is very drastic, which means the intensity of the light will reduce from here to here very drastically, okay? And as the light moves backwards, the intensity of the light will drop. Every time the distance between the subject and the light doubles, the light drops to 25% of the intensity from the previous position. But the main thing is the way the light behaves on the model. When the light is close to the subject, the light fall off will be very drastic. As you go back and keep taking shots, you will see the background becoming brighter and brighter. Of course, I have a TTL controlling this battery operated AD600B. And of course, I'll need your help, Vinu, this time too. Okay, bring it close. And of course, you need to keep the light facing the backdrop too. Bring it in. Yeah, that's it. Oh, okay. I'm shooting at 4.5. And okay, now, Vinu, can you bring the light double that distance? Okay, and the next shot. Nice. Okay, wow, the background is slowly becoming brighter. Go back, please. And maybe you will have to increase the height slightly because to compensate for the distance. Go back and point at her, and same aperture, same everything else, and okay, and back, okay, and make sure that the light is pointing at her, okay, and bye. To understand this point, it's important to see these images in a much larger scale alongside. So I think we should take these images onto a bigger screen, which is our desktop. So over to our desktop. Look at these four images. Simple, straightforward. You don't need too much of explanation to understand this. First shot, where the light was very close to the object. She is lit well. I have not changed the aperture and the shutter speed and the distance from the background. But you can see the background really gone dark here. The next shot, light is slightly far away. Now here, of course, we've not measured any distance like we did in the previous video. All we did was we just, you know, casually took it away and away from the model. This was the next shot. Of course, Isha's face is lit well. So is the background. Background was now slowly becoming brighter, which means if somebody was standing there, he would also become more brighter. And of course, Isha's face is brightly lit. And you can also see the shadows becoming less and less pronounced. In the third image, light was moved a little more away from the model. she is bright and the background is now a little more brighter than the previous image. So now the background and the model both are getting same importance or same weightage, so to speak. In the first image, the foreground or our subject got more importance and the background got underexposed. Now here, now her face and the background is very similar, as in they both are getting same weightage. And in the last one, where the light was really far away, her face and the backdrop got exposed equally. Well, obviously, when you want the background to go dark or underexposed, all you have to do is to bring the light closer to your subject and the background automatically goes underexposed due to the greater light fall off. And as you take the light away and away from our subject, the background also becomes brighter and brighter and finally become equally lit. Well, when you are doing a large group, for example, you can work with the same light if you keep the light away from the subject. If you bring that light closer to the subject with that same light source, you can exclude, or we can give one person prominence and underexpose the rest in the group. So if you found this beneficial to you, please make sure that your friend photographers or friend enthusiasts also know about our channel, because we've been working very hard at bringing our understanding of photography to you in the best possible way we can. And we request you that if you are benefited from it, please don't forget to share it with your folks. So hope to get back to you with another interesting video on photography. Bye for now.